Hey, fourth grade. So we're going to continue to add on to our spy house. And what we're going to do is we're going to make a little teleporter that will take us to the moon. So real quick, what we need to do is we need to build a new scene that we can go to. So I'm going to click up here in the left-hand corner, click on this little scene tab, add a new scene. In this scene, I'm going to go to environment and edit and grab the moon. Now, I need to put a rocket here that'll take us back to Earth. So I'm going to close this scene tab. I'm going to go to library and transport and click on air, and there's my rocket. And I can see that it's kind of laying down like that. I want it to stand straight up. So I'm going to click on this rotate button, and I'm going to click on this red axis, and I'm going to tilt it back up to 90 degrees and then turn that off. I'm going to click on this little up down drag to lift button, drag that up so that it is standing like that, and move this in front of the camera. And I'm going to spin it a little bit because you can kind of see this discoloration here. That's the door, and I want a door. So I'm going to click on this rocket, go to animation and choose open. I'm also going to go to code and say using CoBlocks. And then I just want to put it like a little computer in here so that we can launch the rocket. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to building, and I need a little pedestal to put it on. So I'm going to grab this pedestal, click A for attach, and put it here. And then I'm going to just move it back a little bit, and then I'm going to raise it up to just about below the window like that. And then I'm going to go to items, and I'm going to scroll over a little bit. I'm going to use this laptop here, press A again, and attach it to this. And just like before, I'm going to double click on the cuboid that I used, go to code, and using code. And the same thing with the laptop, go to code and use code. And now all I have to do is this, double click on the rocket, animation, close, and then we're going to go to code and program this. So this is going to be a CoBlock script. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to go to events, and we're going to say when cuboid is clicked, but we're going to start off with when the rocket is clicked, and go to actions and set the animation of the rocket to open. That way we can open up and get into the rocket. And then the next thing we want to do is go to events again and bring when rocket is clicked. But this time we're going to click on the laptop. So when we click on the laptop, we're going to go to actions, and actually we're going to go to transform, and we're going to move laptop. Now we don't want to move the laptop, we want to move the cuboid, and since they're attached, the laptop will go with it. We're going to move it probably about, maybe 5 meters down. And that will get it out of our way, and we'll do that in 2 seconds. The next thing we want to go to do is actions and set the animation of the rocket to closed, so the door will close. And then we want to go to transform and move, and we're going to move the rocket. Now the weird thing is you would think that we want to move the rocket up, but because we tilted the rocket, we actually want to move the rocket forward. And I'm going to say about 100 meters, and we'll do that in maybe 5 seconds. Okay, so what that does now is when I click on play, I can click on the rocket and open the door, and then I gotta hit the space bar to jump up here. I can click on the laptop and it'll move out of the way. The door will close, and you can see now that we're launching up in the air. Okay, so the last thing that we wanna do is we now want to go to control and scroll down a little bit here, and we wanna go to scene. And we're going to do scene one. So that'll take us back to our scene one, which is our spy house. Now we've got to actually get to the moon. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to our scene one. And I'm just going to build like a little kitchen over here in the corner. So what I'm going to do is, I think it's in housing. And I'm going to scroll over here. We'll go to kitchen. And you can see that I've got these bottom cabinets. And I'm just going to bring one bottom cabinet out and put it there. And a second bottom cabinet out and put it there. Actually, you know what? I'm going to delete that. Let's use the sink. That's more kitchen-like. So we'll put that there like that. And then these are sort of top cabinets. So I'm just going to put this against the wall and raise it up. And I obviously need to make my walls a little bit bigger or my cabinets a little bit smaller. But for right now, this will just have to do. So we'll do that. And then I'm going to right-click and duplicate this and put another one right next to it like that. Okay, so now I've got a space like that, and I'm going to just take the oven. I'm going to put it, let's put it on this side over here. And I think there is a refrigerator somewhere. There it is. And I'm going to put the refrigerator here. Okay, now if they don't move perfectly, you can always click on snapping and take snapping off. And then I have more freedom to move these sort of where I want. Okay. So now I've got my little mini kitchen, and I'm going to double click on all of these and have them available in code blocks because we need to get them out of our way. So code blocks for all of them. All right. And I'm just going to call this kitchen. That's all right. It's because this will be sink. Yep. And this one here, we're going to go to code. I'm going to call this kitchen cupboard. I'm just going to change this kitchen cupboard left. And this one will be kitchen cupboard. Instead of one, we're going to call this right, but also available in code blocks. Okay, so now all of our things are available in code blocks. And what I want to do is I want to drop the refrigerator and the stove down, and I'm going to move these cabinets off to the side. And what we're going to have is we're going to go to building, and I'm going to bring out this cuboid here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this cuboid, I'm going to flatten it a lot, and I'm going to stretch it out, and I'm going to raise it up kind of like this. And I'm probably just going to go maybe about this size like this. Okay, and this is going to be our portal, and you'll see what we're going to do with that in a minute. So I'm going to double click on that, and I'm just going to call this portal and yet let it be used in code blocks. Okay, so let's start coding this stuff. We're going to call a new sprite or a new script up in code blocks, and I'm going to go down and rename this to kitchen. Okay, so the first thing that we want to do is we want to have one of the cabinets be responsible for starting this. So I'm going to say this one here, which is just the regular kitchen cupboard left, right? So I'm going to go to events. And when fridge is clicked, we're going to say when kitchen cupboard left is clicked. And so what we want to do is we want to drop the refrigerator and the stove down. So we're going to go to transform, and we're going to do move fridge, and we're going to change this one to stove. And we're going to drop it down, let's say 3 meters, excuse me. 3 meters down, and then, oops, this one will also be 3 meters down. But I want you to notice something when I do this. If I click on play here, go over to my kitchen, I click on my cabinet, notice how it does one at a time. I want them both to happen at the same time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do something called run parallel. And so if I just come up here to this little search bar and type in run, you can see that here it is, this run parallel. And I'm going to put this inside the when click statement like this. And I can just close that. Now, if I put move fridge in this space and move stove in this space, notice that when I click play now, they run at the exact same time. Perfect. So that's just what I want. And now I want to move these cabinets off to the side. So I'm going to do the exact same thing. I'm going to bring out another run parallel, which should be in control here. Right there. I'm going to put this after the, whoops, I put it inside. I'm going to put this after the first run parallel, right? So now we're going to move the different cabinets. So I'm going to bring this out once and twice. Now I need to do this 4 times, but I've only got 2 slots. So what do? I click on the gear, add a task, do this again. Click on the gear, add a task, and do this again. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to move kitchen cupboard left, and we'll move it left, and maybe 2 meters. That might be too much. We'll just have to see. This will be kitchen cupboard right. We're going to move this right in 2 meters. Okay. And this will be kitchen counter. So this is the one on the left. So but it's facing the other way. I think I got this wrong. I think this one's right, excuse me. And this one's left because it's facing us. And so kitchen counter, this one's going to go right 2 meters in 1 second. And this is going to be kitchen counter with sink, which is this one. So this one will go left 2 meters. All right, so now I click on play. And we're going to scroll over here and take a look. So there goes those things. 2 meters, way too far. So let's just switch that real quick. We're going to say, let's move this down to 1, and 1, and 1, and 1. And we're going to click on play again. Try this one more time. Take a look at it. Oh, that's almost perfect. Close enough for right now. Okay, So you can always adjust the size of this, right? So if it was just a little bit too wide, I can just sort of bring it in and just sort of bring it in like that. Now, I don't want to see this portal right at the start. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Actions, and I'm going to say Set Opacity of Portal, and I'm going to put this right after when Play is clicked, so not inside here. We're going to set that down to 0. And now you see that when I play it, you can't see that portal anymore, which means that when we go back to our script, now after we've done these two run parallels, now we can go back and we can set the opacity of the portal back up to 100. And then we're going to do something a little bit fun. We're going to go to Control. We're going to bring out our forever. And then we're going to go to Actions. And let's do Set Color of the Fridge. And right now, actually, we're going to set the color of the portal. And we're going to scroll down here. And I think we've got the choice of going random color. So it's going to be in data. So if you scroll down in data, you can see this one that says random color. And we're going to put this in here where it says white. Okay. And we will now say that events, when we need a little collision, and we want when, not when portal is hovered, I just saw it, I thought, when portal collides with portal. So we're going to bring this out, and we're going to just stick it after, we're going to stick it outside when this kitchen cupboard is clicked, so this will be way down the bottom, and we want to do when camera, and I should turn the, I got to click on the camera, and go to code, make it available in code blocks. So we say when the camera collides with the portal, then we are going to go to, I'm just going to type in scene so I can find it faster. Whoops, there it is. Go to scene. We put this in enter. Go to scene, scene two. All right, so now let's take a look at what we got. Come over here. We click on our cupboards. They spread out, and notice the portal blinking like that. I can click, hit the portal, and I end up going to the moon. And then I can go back onto my rocket, click on the laptop, and we take off and launch. And then once we get about 100 meters up in the air, we go back to our spy house. Okay, hope that all made sense. Have yourselves a great week, and we will talk to you later.